And now, World Improv Network proudly presents Community Court.
Everyone, please rise for the Most Honorable Judge Kenneth Vacaro.
Thank you very much, Bailiff Peter Schmidt. Looks like today in my court we've got a real doozy. Mr. Willington is suing himself for burning himself with coffee. So I guess in this case the plaintiff is Mr. Peter Schmidt, and then the defendant, Mr. Peter Schmidt, would you care to clarify who the defendant is?
Yes, the defendant is the plaintiff, sir.
All right then. Well, let's start with
Your Honor, I'm here just to be a character witness. I witnessed everything that happened.
Okay, and your name?
Yeah, my name is Mr. Smitherson.
All right, Mr. Smitherson. All right, Mr. Smitherson.
Your Honor, I would just like to say that Mr. Smitherson's testimony is not reliable.
All right. Now you seem to be using a different voice now, Mr. Peter Schmidt.
No, my name is Clarence Ross.
Okay. All right. So we have Mr. Peter Schmidt and Clarence Ross. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
All right, then. So, Clarence, could you maybe speak for Mr. Peter Schmidt as to what exactly happened with this coffee burning?
Yes, Your Honor. It was a huge misunderstanding. Mr. Peter Schmidt was just hanging out, eating his morning bagel with a cup of...
What kind of bagel was it, just for the record, and also my own curiosity?
It was poppy seed.
Oh, were like the seeds in the bagel, or were they, where they just kind of put them on like a glaze?
Yeah, they were on top like a great glaze, but Mr. Peter Schmidt added his own layer of sesame seeds on top of the schmear.
Your Honor, I have a piece of this bagel left over. And let me present that to you for evidence.
Thank you for putting that in a Ziploc baggie.
And as you can clearly see, there is a glaze on top of this bagel. Mr. Peter Schmidt, is it completely accurate on how he put that on top of his bagel?
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Smitherson.
Look, I don't think my bagel-eating habits are on trial here, Your Honor.
I'm sorry, is this Mr. Peterschmidt or
yes.
Clarence Ross?
Yes, this is Kyle Peterschmidt.
Oh, Kyle, okay.
Mr. Kyle Peterschmidt.
All right then, could you maybe continue the story that Mr. Clarence Ross did as to this coffee burning? So there was a glazed bagel with sesame seeds, I guess, and poppy seeds, is that correct? Was it both poppy and sesame?
Yes, there was.
That's a lot. It's too many seeds.
I'm sorry. I didn't hear Mr. Ross's story. So,
you can't hear yourself talk, or you can't hear your like different personalities, or
Mr. Your Honor. I just want to say it's because of the poppy seeds that his medication failed him that day, and since then he's had a split personality disorder. And I think that's really what's going on here, in my judgment, as observing him for the last several weeks.
And I see that you're wearing a white coat, Mr. Smitherson, but do you actually have any medical degrees?
I do have a degree in cosmology, and that use a lot of medicines to make people look pretty. So I think that that's pretty valid and relative.
Okay, and by medicines, you mean?
Well, pharmaceutical chemicals and products that were provided to us by fine, upstanding companies like Lancome and such.
Okay, so like lipstick, or are you talking like Xanax, or?
Well, people don't realize that Xanax is actually made out of Lancome lipstick. It's the baby blue color lipstick that's ground up and dehydrated into a fine powder. And once those chemicals are dehydrated into a fine powder, the properties are completely different, and it goes from beautification in order to physically stabilize somebody.
Objection, Your Honor. Objection, Your Honor. I don't see what this has to do with the coffee spillage.
Oh, yeah. No, me neither, but it certainly is interesting, isn't it? Okay, all right. Hey, we're getting... All right, let's get back to your story since it's so gosh darn important.
Well, thank you.
So where were you when you were drinking this coffee or when this coffee spilled or...
I was sitting on my front porch. I had just returned from the local coffee shop, the Jumping Bean.
Okay. Yeah, it's kind of a clever name, I guess.
Yes, and... Well, I was sitting on my porch, and, well,
It's all right. This is a safe place. As you can see, there's hardly anybody in the pews, or the, I don't know what you call them in a courthouse, but I call them pews just because they look like it.
Oh, okay.
It's okay. Go ahead. You can tell.
Okay. There was a loud noise, and some shaking, and the coffee just spilled all over me. And one second I'm taking a sip, and the next thing I know, it's all over
okay,
me.
Okay, okay, let's slow down now. All right, bailiff, could you hand the defendant a tissue?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, hey, that's. I didn't know you got those things embroidered.
Oh, yes, I.
You did that? You do embroidery?
Yes, I do a lot of crafts, Your Honor.
Well, gosh, Cliff, I didn't know that about you.
Oh, yes, well, we don't hang out that much, Your Honor.
No, I guess not. We should, though. You're a cool guy.
Oh, thank you, Your Honor.
Anyway, all right, so all emotions aside, or, I mean, as best we can, Mr. Peterschmidt, What can you replicate this big noise that occurred and startled you? What did it sound like exactly?
The big noise that you're referring to, the time I spilled the coffee?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, there was an incredibly loud sound. It was just it was a thunderclap. It was like a thunderclap.
I was right there when that was happening, Your Honor. What was happening, there was a marching band from the local high school coming down the street right at that moment, and the drummers all hit it at the same time.
Ooh, that would make a very loud noise, and I imagine that would be very startling, especially for someone with such an emotionally vulnerable status such as you have.
Especially after being toxified by poppy seeds on top of a bagel.
Absolutely, absolutely. So far we have an intoxicated man who is off in who knows what realm, cloud 9, 8, or 10, you know what I mean, off of poppy seeds and sesame seeds, getting startled by a marching band.
Your Honor, and I have spent years building up a tolerance to poppy seeds.
Your Honor, he's somewhat borderline addicted, and that's why I tried to take some of my cosmetics to help with the addiction as well.
Mr. Smitherson, your efforts to help cure this man are much appreciated by me personally and by the state.
Thank you, Your Honor.
So, Mr. Peterschmidt, you said there was a noise and then some shaking?
My name's Mr. Ross. Mr. Clarence Ross.
Okay, I'm sorry, because I can't keep up with who I'm talking to. You know, I mean, I can see that you kind of get this grimace on your face, Mr. Ross. I mean, as opposed to Mr. Peterschmidt, who's always just grinning. But at the same time, it's like, you know, you're still same body, you know what I mean? Or you don't, because you're like a separate...
I don't understand what you're talking about. I thought we were dealing with the coffee...
Oh, we are. We are. So tell me about it, because I don't know what you know. You know?
Well, like I said, I was just drinking the coffee, and there's a loud noise, and the next thing I know is I've spilled coffee all over my lap, and it's burning. It is burning so badly. I had to go to the ER, and they had to put various salves and balms all over my lap region.
Including your crotch?
Yes, Your Honor.
Does it sound too bad?
Your Honor, I just want to add that Mr. Peterschmidt is suing himself not only for the $2.95 that he paid for the coffee, you know, down at the coffee store, but he's also suing for the $49.98 in medicine that I gave him that is no longer valuable.
Hmm. Well, I think I've heard enough to make a decision. Mr. Peterschmidt, I've got $2.99 in my pocket right here, so... You know, there's that. and change. Sorry, I don't have any bills on me right now.
Well, can Mr. Bailiff Cliff by chance possibly get that $49 out of his pocket and give it to Mr. Peter Schmidt as well?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, if it'll move us forward. I've been having a lot of success selling my crafts on Etsy lately, so I'm kind of rolling in it.
Now, Cliff, that's not necessary. It is my judgment that the $49.99 shall not be paid because I don't want to feed this man's addiction anymore.
Oh, all right then, Your Honor.
And that concludes this case.
Let's go outside live to the court where we have the interview post-trial with Mr. Peter Schmidt and Mr. Clarence Ross. Let's go outside, Richard.
Hi there. Yes, I'm here with the defendant and plaintiff. I guess. How do you feel about the ruling? You got your $2.99, but not the $49.99.
Well, I guess I'm glad that I got something out of it. I'm still in incredible pain. It really hurts to walk.
Yeah, there's some blood on your pants.
Yes, I'm probably going back to.
Whoa! So, oh my God, are you okay, sir?
Yes. I'm just in pain in my lapel region, but otherwise I'm fine, thank you.
And I'm talking to Mr. Clarence Ross now, is that correct?
Yes, my name is Clarence Ross.
Do you think after this incident you'll continue drinking coffee?
Yes. Yes, I will.
Well, you heard it straight from the courtroom. This man will continue drinking coffee, and it's been an exciting day here in the court.